this, let me tell you, you excited. I'm excited. Look at what we have right here. We have Zomba and Jen on the screen right now. I have waited for this day. I've been waiting. I'm sorry.
Yes.
I haven't gotten to commentate a Jen set in forever. And now we have the classic match of just Xeno.
And Jen already starting off with a really clean string right there, getting 45 using the reverse snare. As you were saying, this is a New York City classic that we have not been able to see for a while because Jen isn't competing as much. But I'm really excited to see this set. I hope Zomba's been on a tear, so it'll be interesting to see like the newer like top dog get taken down by like a veteran of New York City Smash.
Kind
of getting taken down right now.
Oh wow!
Really aggressive start from Jen right there, not letting Rob set up a single thing. Like, okay, you cannot get your nair out because my nair is here.
Literally. And speaking of aggression, I just love the way that Jen is placing a lot of these nairs. It's just essentially a mix-up, a whole like block stream mix-up on shield. And you forgot about freaking Palutena, not no more. You thought it was a era of freaking Wi-Fi characters. Absolutely not. No, thank you. But getting into this game, we're already only at 70% on their first dog, and Jen is just continuing to pile on the damage here. Looking at trying to get off ledge right now, this is nothing to a goddess.
And these nairs have gotten so much mileage because every time Zomba tries to start a nair of his own, that move just stays out, you know? So it'll obviously beat it before it comes out, and that's such a strong thing to be able to shut down Rob right there. But really clean stuff. They know that Paulo is not going to be able to snap ledge from that distance. So Zomba with the side B. But this could be the stock right here if Jen is as good as chasing down as they have been.
For sure. And I definitely love the way that, you know, Jen is actually really using this stage to their advantage. Very nice ledge trap coming in. The thing that I really do love. Okay. I really love about Jen is that their ledge trapping situations are just so good. You know, of course, Palutena is really good, but they, you know, even with all of the nerfs, they have been able to just show us that, you know, this is the king of New York. Hello.
Yeah, this has been I haven't seen Zomba lose like this as Xeno. You know, Zomba's just getting like destroyed. Like.
Listen, it's because you haven't seen one of the best people in New York in like forever.
But it's true.
Yes, very nice back throw, putting Zomba right back off stage and threatening a ledge or an edge guard situation, but not really gonna get too much off of it. Very nice situation from Zomba putting Jen right back off stage, but Jen is just retaliating with the freaking gyro. This is so crazy. Back throw, get him off stage again. This is crazy.
You know, Jen was saying on Twitter, I believe, that like everyone forgot how to fight Rob with the recent tear of Rob's at Luzino lately, and was determined to show everyone. You're showing everyone right here. Zomba could not get anything going that entire game. That was the Jen show the entire time. Like Zomba, like every advantage state they got just was like very brief, and Jen just held the ledge for minutes.
Period. But this is, honestly, this is kind of a throwback to the past at this point. Literally so good to see some nice offline Xeno action coming in from one of my favorite people. Y'all already know, Jen is one of my favorite people, especially with Palutena. Yeah, I can't forget about Palutena.
Yeah, Jen's Palo is really fun to watch. They definitely like go in a lot. It's really entertaining. And right here, we're gonna see, hopefully, for Zomba's sake, a different start.
Oh my god! Okay! Period!
I was gonna say a different start than the last game because Zomba got essentially zero to death that game, but they got quite literally zero to death this time. What a bold double dare coming out from Jen, completely calling out where Zomba was gonna position himself. And this is a domination right here. I was not expecting this.
Oh my god. That's so crazy. I'm just a little bit in shock from that very nice thought coming in from Jen. But right now, we're kind of getting a little bit of neutral going on, just throwing a lot of moves out on shield and kind of threatening a lot of the tools that, you know, Paulo still has. You may have thought that even with all these nerfs that Paulo isn't good, but we're seeing a really good use.
Definitely.
And a very nice read with that air dodge right there, putting Zomba back into a bad position, but immediately flipping the roles back onto Jen, but this is looking a little bit scary.
Ooh. And if you saw right there, Jen had
ooh!
So clean. Because Palu, normally that down tilt's like super free in a lot of characters, but Rob's one of the few characters that you actually have to call out the timing because Rob can mix it up so much. And Jen is just knowing where Zomba is going to be. This is on the verge of a three stock. I can't tell you, when has Zomba gotten three stocked in recent Xeno history? Probably Tilde, but for the most part.
But I really love the way that it's kind of just playing with the way Zomba truly wants to play this game. You know, we've seen a lot of situations where people just kind of...
Oh my god. Ah! I mean, that was... I was not ready for that. I was not ready for that. I... Wow.
That is so crazy, but I just really love the way that not only was Jen being super aggressive and neutral, they were being super aggressive and catching, you know, a lot of Zomba's landings. Offstage interactions were just completely flipped around where Jen should have died, but he didn't. And then not only that, he flipped it on Zomba, so Zomba was right back offstage and never let Zomba recover the way that Zomba wants to. You know, a lot of times we've been seeing when we watch a lot of Zomba sets previously, we see them get away with so many suts being getting away with offstage interruptions.